to tell you about Bob and some of his family. Bob's sister Phyllis had a son, Mike, and he married a Mormon girl. They had 9 children. And then I asked Mike when I called him the other day, how many grandchildren do you have? He said, 25. And I said, how in the world do you keep track of all of them? So he said, well, they put everything on the refrigerator. So I can imagine the refrigerator is covered. So that was just some of his family. There's all the other nieces and nephews too. Jade, my daughter-in-law, is in Thailand right now. She went there because her sister was having surgery, and she won't be back till the 21st. But Bob loved Jade, and he was always asking me how she was. Years ago, he said that he built a house for his mother. I don't know when this is. He was a very talented person, and he painted pictures. One of them was on the video, and he painted actually 4 pictures, that's all. And the reason that he gave me was, he said, somebody said, I dare you to do it. I bet you can't do it. So he went and he painted his 4 pictures, and he did a beautiful job. And he, Carl has one, and the rest of us don't have any, he gave them away. He also took a class in stained glass after he retired. And he didn't do something simple and easy. He made lamps, beautiful lamps, which also were on the video. And he stopped that, I think, because his eyesight was bothering him, and he sort of got tired of doing it. When Bob was in the South Pacific, he wasn't in actual combat, but he worked on planes because he had taken a course in electronics. And he said most of the time, what he did was clean the planes. And he was in Saipan. I don't know what other place, I can't remember anymore. One thing he always told me about that he thought was really neat, they gave packs of cigarettes to the natives, and then the natives climbed the coconut trees and threw coconuts down to them. When he got back from the service, he told me he hitched rides on freight cars. Maybe he did that before, I don't know. And then I guess he settled down some finally. He did a bunch of dating because he joined the Lutheran singles group. And he told me that's why he didn't have any money, because he spent it all on dating and getting his shirts cleaned at the laundry. I never saw his apartment when I was over in Maywood. I taught at Zion Lutheran School when I met him. And he said he painted his apartment pink. And the reason I knew this was because he had pink paint spots all over him. And I said, what in the world is that from? And he said, well, I painted it pink because I thought you'd like it. But I never did see his apartment. And before I left to go back east to take care of a granddad who was sick, he asked me to marry him. And I said, no, there's too many years between us. But after I got back to New York, he kept calling and calling and calling. And I finally said, okay. After we were married, he liked to drive around. And we'd go out on the freeway. And then we'd come back on Foothill Boulevard, and we'd go out to dinner. He liked his Chevy cars, and he had, he liked to go up to Bonnes Ferry, Iowa. visit his sister. And every year we went off to Bonas Ferry, it never changed. I said, let's go someplace else. No, he wanted to see his sister. And then one year I got tired of it and I went to Europe. And he went up with Carl by himself. And he still kept going to Bonas Ferry after that. We got to see a lot of things on our trips. We went to through Utah and sometimes up to Washington and Oregon, always to Bonas Ferry, Idaho. And Bob usually sat in the car while Paul and I got out and looked at things. And first thing you know, beep, beep. Okay, we had to go back and sit in the car and take off again. One year we went through Beaver, Utah, and we stopped around 3 p.m. usually, and Bob had a drink and relaxed, and Paul and I took off and went to a rock shop that's for minerals. And what happened, we heard this tremendous bang while we were in the store, and somebody had, this old farmer, had backed his car into his truck, into our car, and smashed the side, the driver's side. And so I was scared to death to go back and tell him. But we did, and we kept going to Bonas Ferry, Idaho, even though the side of the car was smashed, and he said, we'll fix it when we get back. Bob didn't believe in missing church ever because it meant a lot to him. Every Sunday he took us to church. First we went to Zion Maywood, and then we switched here to Messiah because Paul had to ride his bike and Maywood was too far, so he rode his bike here to church. Bob always sat with me, no matter where it was, Zion or here, in the back of the church. And I never did get him to move forward. It was always in the back. But he got us here every Sunday. When we got our divorce, he moved to Idaho. And after a while, he wanted to come back here. So for 3 years, I took care of him because when he came back, we discovered he had a lot of things wrong with him, beginning Alzheimer's, diabetes, kidney disease, and a lot of other things. And then I couldn't do it anymore, and I had to have surgery. So he moved to Country Inn of Downey, where he resided for 8 years. And at the end of 8 years, he called me a week ago Monday and said, I have to go to the hospital, I can't breathe. So we took him there, I took him there, and I was scared to death because I thought maybe he might die on the way. But I got him there, and that was very hard the last week. But all through everything,